Good morning. I'm Bill Roper from UNC Healthcare, and it's my delight and honor to welcome you here today. We want to highlight for you, our friends in the news media, and others across this region and state, the story of what's happening here at Wakebrook. It's a partnership, lots of local organizations and institutions, the state of North Carolina, and families and patients are coming together to craft a new way of delivering mental health, behavioral health services in this community. I want to thank my good friend Secretary Vosh for being here today, but especially for the tireless effort she is putting forward on behalf of our state citizens to improve not only mental health services, but health and human services generally. We're glad to partner to solve the health problems facing our state, including mental health problems. Patients who need mental health services often end up in local hospital emergency departments. That's been a pressing issue here in the area of Wake Med, but at Rex, Duke Health Raleigh, and other institutions more broadly. To help meet the need for expanded services for this fragile and important population, UNC Healthcare has assumed administration of the Wakebrook Crisis Care Facility earlier this year. Wakebrook ensures Wake County patients seeking mental health services have greater access to a high quality, streamlined care experience, with the added goal of alleviating the burden on local emergency departments and other healthcare providers. In the past year, we've worked with Alliance Behavioral Health, Wake County, Wake Med, and others to ensure to enhance services available here at Wakebrook, and we believe things are surely headed in the right direction for patients. In February, we opened the Crisis and Assessment Clinic, where we serve about 400 patients every month. In May, we opened the Addiction Treatment Center, providing 16 residential beds for patients. In July, we assumed operation of 16 facility-based crisis beds designed for shorter stays for patients in crisis. And we recently opened another 16 beds for inpatient treatment for a higher level of mental health care. Our plans now call for adding 12 more inpatient beds, raising the level of behavioral care available in Wake County, and reducing the strain on hospital emergency departments. In addition, we formed an Assertive Community Treatment Team, or ACT team, to provide or to improve outpatient care and to provide a more proactive approach to treating behavioral health problems. And we've also opened an outpatient clinic just down the road from here. The UNC STEP Community Clinic will improve the treatment and management of more than 500 seriously and persistently mentally ill patients in Wake County. We've also worked to expand medical services available on site here at Wakebrook, avoiding complicated transfers to other facilities for patient care. We've begun to increase our coordination with Wake EMS and the Wake County Jail to ensure patients in need of mental health services are referred to Wakebrook for additional care and evaluation. Wakebrook is just one part of a larger approach to improving mental health services in Wake County. We will continue to work closely with Wake County, Alliance Behavioral Health, and other partners to improve the quality of and access to behavioral health services in our community. This is a beginning. We have a long way to go, but I'm really pleased to welcome you here today to celebrate the progress thus far and to look forward to what lies ahead. At this time, I'm pleased to introduce Dr. Brent Myers, Director of Wake County EMS. On behalf of UNC Healthcare and others, we welcome our chance to partner with you. Dr. Myers.